What's up, YouTube? So today I'm going to show you how to downgrade your iOS 10 device back to iOS 9.3.2. If you guys have updated to the beta, I'm sure you'll discover that it's not all it's cracked up to be, seeing that it's a beta. It does have bugs and glitches, so unless you have a test device, it's not really something you want to use every day. Thankfully, you can go backwards. Just follow the link below to ipsw.me. And from here, you just want to select your device. So I have an iPhone 5 that I'm going to downgrade. And make sure you choose which model iPhone 5 you have. And then the firmwares you can restore to are in green. So 9.3.2 as of this video is good. As for the device, you'll just want to make sure that your Find My iPhone is off. You should know how to do that. It's under Settings and iCloud. As long as you have that removed and you've downloaded this firmware can take like 10-20 minutes to download depending on your computer and internet speed. Anyways, you'll want to head to iTunes here, and if you follow my mouse just right up here, once your device is connected, you can just click on it here, and this is the iPhone 5 here on iOS 10. Now, to actually start the downgrade, you're going to take your keyboard here, and you're going to hold the Option key. So the Option key is right here. You want to hold the Option key and click on, if you see my mouse here, Restore Phone. Now what this is going to do is this is going to bring up a Finder window, and you can navigate to the firmware you downloaded on this web page here. So that's really important part of doing this. Once you get that, which I have mine saved under download and here, you can just hit open. This will wipe all the data off your device, so make sure you have a backup of it before you begin. And here we go. This process takes about 10 minutes or so, depending on the device. So once that process is complete, you'll be greeted back to another reboot with another loading bar. This takes about 5 minutes again, so just sit tight until we're on the upgrade or welcome screen. Now iTunes should detect the iPhone again, and we're just loading up. I will. will need to put a valid SIM in here, but here we go. We're back on iOS 9.3.2. I'll just quickly activate the device and then show you.
Alright, so we got a valid SIM in here. We just need to activate the device, which it should do. Just have to join the Wi-Fi. So we are back on iOS 9. Thanks for watching, guys. Make sure you like this video, subscribe to the channel for more, and we'll see you again next time. Cheers.